Church with instrumental 12th Street. Tony's a friend of mine I met about 11 or 12 years ago. He walked into, I think, our first songwriter's night on a Thursday night at Crescent Moon Coffee in the old facility. That's the one across the street with the great courtyard and fountain. And we were stuck back in the little room behind the fountain area. And Tony came in the first night, first week. He just put his guitar in the corner and listened. And the next week he came, he took the guitar out and he tuned it. And then he put it back in the case and he listened some more. Finally, on the third week, after everyone else had sung or played or talked or whatever, he said, "Can I play a song or two?" We said, "Sure, you know, that's why we're here." And I guess he was comfortable enough by that time that he had some idea that you might not actually bite his head off if he missed a note or two. So with that, Tony played and we were all entranced and we became good friends. And so along that road, here we are now, Tony Church.
This is a short instrumental piece called 500 Nations of Native America. I'd like to express gratitude to Mojava for providing the house. To Rex for providing direction, intelligent direction. And to all of you for providing the circle of energy tonight. Very much appreciate it. I do not sing. You will thank me for that someday. But I do write words that never make it into my songs. But this particular set of music and words were inspired by something I read in Life magazine 1947 about a splendid, glamorous young woman who jumped from the Empire State Building. And I was profoundly moved by this. And the reflection I got from this young woman, her name was Evelyn McHale, she was 23 years old, was that life is precious. Life is hard. Even when it's easy, life is hard. And the reflection that I got from this was that our best recourse as human beings, perhaps our only recourse as human beings, is to support each other and to show compassion for each other. I will set this on the table. And, my lovely cousin Cindy came tonight. Haven't seen her maybe 5 times in my lifetime, so I'm very glad she's here tonight. Could you please take this and set it on the table there if anybody wants to take a look at it? And I'm gonna set up and start playing. Here's what I wrote. Wrote something real brief. It's called May Day. A flash striking beauty, well-dressed and walking tall, landed in New York City one day. Stranded, she smiled divinely one day, warming her friends and family's lives like ever, like never before. She had fought and broken up with her lover, her fiancé, her best friend one day. She wrote a letter to whoever, crying she would make a terrible wife one day. She missed her brother killed in the war, flying a lightning over an ocean one day. She stepped on a subway and got off near the Empire State Building one day. She stifled her pain and lost, sobbing silently, strongly one day. She turned heads. Old women and bold men, dreamy and dead, absolute, awestruck by her terrestrial beauty and fleeting moments on a teeming sidewalk of mists and shadows one day. So she followed a force into a marble chamber and a ride up a famous tall building one day. The operator wondering worriedly, "Are you all right now, miss?" in his elevator one day. The doors open to a thick fog and the soft roar of post-war New York below one day. Her heart broke. A voice spoke and her eyes rained, a doe stepping carefully, scared and slow one day. She removed her shoes, she stepped up the parapet, she climbed the minaret. Sorry. She took another step, she leapt, flying in mist, whispering, I'm sorry, I'm so sorry one day.
Excuse me.
So another hand for Sig and Tony.